Hi.
Tony here.
Long story short, we got a question for you real quick. Would you date someone much older than you? I was having a conversation like this with a friend recently, and in it, my opinion was that there's nothing wrong with it, assuming you're old enough to make the decision, of course. But I did think of one point of caution to consider, that someone in their 30s or even 40s is in a very different place in life. And that got me thinking, someone in that age group really is in a different place in their life. I mean, yeah, this is pretty obvious stuff, but we all only get to live one time, so we don't usually sit down and really think about what it feels like. If you're around my age, early 20s, someone who is in their 40s has been conscious dealing with life and all the good and the bad that comes with it for about twice as long as we have. Can you imagine what that does to someone? I can, I'm 21. But I'm sure I'll have a better idea someday. But of course, that's small compared to people nearing the end of their lives. People are living longer today than at any point in human history. Once upon a time, most people kicked the bucket one way or another by the time they were 50. And that's being generous, of course. But it's not like people couldn't grow old back then. So when the rare person did make it to be 80 or whatever, they became elders. People who had likely lived through multiple generations and were often revered for their experience. This is pretty interesting. Hang on a second. Better. As we sprint into the 21st century with all our technology and science and medicine, we're starting to see what can happen when people really get a good shot at living. The oldest people alive generally claim to be in the ballpark of 100 to 150 years old. Last year, a man in Indonesia claimed to be 146 at the time of his death. Records for many of these people tend to be unreliable, though. The oldest properly identified person to ever live died in 1997 at the age of 122 and a half years. If you take a look at the list of the oldest verified people, most of them, including the current oldest person, clock in at about 117 years. Modern science is shaping up to make these lifespans normal, if not short, by the time we make it there. Even if you're already middle-aged, science is nuts. You might be stuck here for a while. In part two of this short series, I'm going to ask what you might expect to experience in your long lifetime, but right now, I want to ask the same question of those who've already done it. Those who have lived vast, long lives during the greatest transition of culture and technology in human history. Today, on Long Story Short, we're asking this. If you were born in 1900 and lived to today, and some people have, what would you have lived through? All right, first things first, 100 plus years of world history just isn't gonna happen in a lunch break. At least, not the majority of it, or even half. But I'm gonna try to hit some of the big stuff. Your first memories start to properly stick at around the age of 3. News wasn't great back then, but let's assume you heard about some of these things as a 3-year-old as they happened because, you know, we gotta start somewhere. So, in 1903, Orville and Wilbur Wright flew the first powered-controlled, heavier-than-air plane at Kitty Hawk, North Carolina. People had been imagining and trying to do this for hundreds of years, but they were the first to do it successfully. Simultaneously, Henry Ford was in the process of organizing the company, which shares his name today, to sell a product which you likely weren't familiar with in 1903. When you are 5 years old, the Russian Revolution begins when Russian troops fire on demonstrators in St. Petersburg. Also, at this time, Albert Einstein is developing his theory of general relativity. In 1908, Ford releases his Model T, the first car to see some commercial success. It had a top speed of about 40 miles or 64 kilometers per hour. In 1910, the Boy Scouts of America are founded. And assuming you're 10 years old and a boy, you could join. Hey, I could not mention them. We go way back. By 1911, planes had improved to the point that they were starting to be used in war, specifically the Turkish-Italian War. Back on this continent, a revolution occurs in Mexico, and Francisco Madero takes control. 1912 sees the Titanic sink, and New Mexico and Arizona are admitted as states to the Union. In 1913, Ford introduces the assembly line, and in 1914, World War I begins with the assassination of some Austrian royalty. At this point, just about all of the European powers have been amassing modern weapons, and they hadn't had the chance to use them yet. So, during your teenage years, they all fight each other in what is, up to that point, the bloodiest conflict in human history. In 1915, Einstein finally publishes his general theory of relativity. By 1917, World War I is really flying off the rails, and the US gets involved. Now let's pick up the pace, because the number of things happening never decreases, especially not in this century. When you're 20 years old, the Bolsheviks take control of Russia, paving the way for the Soviet state that we all become more familiar with in the future. Also, the United States begins its first war on drugs, the prohibition of alcohol. But it's not all bad. If you're a woman, this is the year that you get the right to vote. World War I had ended earlier with a German defeat, and in 1921, Germany was handed the bill for it. Their economy starts to crumble over the next few years as a result. Adolf Hitler and Mussolini will use growing discontent and unchecked nationalism in their own countries, among other things, to gain power. In 1924, Lenin dies in Russia, and despite his instructions to the contrary, Stalin grabs power. He will rule as dictator until his death in almost 30 years. In 1927, the first part-talking motion picture, The Jazz Singer, is released, and it is only now, in 1928, that penicillin is discovered. Prior to this first antibiotic, bacterial infections were a really common way to go. In 1929, Edwin Powell Hubble proposes that the universe is expanding, and spoiler alert, it is. But you're probably not too concerned with this right now, as you are, at this point in time, about to live through one of the worst economic crises in human history, the Great Depression. By the time you are 30, the Nazis are gaining traction in Germany. Spain joins the list of countries to become a republic, and the Star Spangled Banner becomes the national anthem of the United States. Planes continue to improve, and Amelia Earhart becomes the first woman to fly the Atlantic solo in 1932. In 1933, Hitler is appointed Chancellor in Germany, gaining his dictatorial powers. By 1939, Hitler has started taking bites out of other countries, and World War II begins. It is also at this time that Einstein realizes that people are getting close to unlocking the power of nuclear fission. He writes to the President of the United States about his concerns. Gone with the Wind also premieres this year. When you are 41 years old, Pearl Harbor is attacked by Japan, finally dragging the United States properly into World War II. The next year, the United Nations is coming into being, and in Hitler's short-lived empire, the Holocaust begins. In 1945, the war is brought to an end in Europe with an Allied victory. The war is also ended in Japan when the United States, successful in its fission research, drops two atomic bombs on Japan. That same year, the first electronic computer, the ENIAC, is built. Before you are 50, Britain has let go of much of its pre-war colonial holdings, and Korea is split along the land and ideology that still divides it today. A war is fought over this as you mark your first half century alive. Your 50s are marked by a fear of communism, with McCarthyism coming into its own. At this time, the United States is working on even bigger nuclear weaponry, hydrogen bombs in particular. Russia is doing the same. The war in Korea ends, thankfully, without the use of nuclear weapons, but it doesn't accomplish much else. As you move into your 60s, the staring match between the US and the USSR only gets more tense. Diplomatic relations are broken with Cuba following failed attempts at removing their leader from power by the US. The US also begins experimenting with sending people into space at this time, and the USSR develops a 50 megaton hydrogen bomb, the largest explosion in history. All this by your 62nd birthday. In 1963, the first successful artificial heart transplant is performed, even if it only works for 4 days. You probably wouldn't remember this as much as you would remember the president being assassinated, which also happened this year. 4 years and a ton of other events later, the first successful human heart transplant is performed, this time sustaining its user for 18 days. As you near your 70th birthday, the Vietnam War is in full swing, and the practice of segregation that massively oppressed the United States black population comes to an end. Racism, of course, does not, but that's a topic for another video. It is also at this time that humanity pulls off what is, in my opinion, one of our greatest achievements. Neil Armstrong becomes the first person to step foot on the moon. At this point, you're getting pretty old. But the world isn't slowing down. Anti-war protests are now going strong around the country in your early 70s, as 4 students at Kent State University in Ohio are shot dead by National Guardsmen. The voting age is lowered to 18, and in June of 1972, the Watergate scandal begins around then President Richard Nixon. At this point, though, this won't be the first president you've seen not make it through their term. The Vietnam War ends in 1973, and in 1974, the charges of obstruction of justice, failure to uphold laws, and refusal to produce subpoenaed materials are brought against Nixon. He resigns and is pardoned. At the age of 76, you celebrate just over 3/4 of a century at the same time as the US celebrates 200 years. And Jimmy Carter. At this point, there is so much happening in the world, so much that in writing this episode, it's starting to become difficult to choose what to even include. By now, movies and TV are mainstream, Star Wars is a thing, an early form of the internet exists, sort of. AIDS is first identified, and the same year that Ronald Reagan is sworn into office. You are 81 now. The next year, the first permanent artificial heart implantation is performed. The year after that, the 1983 Challenger mission sees the first US spacewalk in 9 years. The Cold War is still going on, of course. A South Korean Boeing 747 is shot down after it is said to stray into USSR airspace, killing all 269 aboard. Not long before your 90th birthday, the Berlin Wall, which had divided the city effectively since the end of World War II, falls. Not long after, short into your 90th year on this earth, the World Wide Web properly launches, bringing the internet to the masses, even if it's a bit slow at first. By 1999, the Cold War has officially ended. Now, much of the conflict relevant to the US is in the Middle East, where it will remain to this day. By the time we hit the year 2000, at which point I am 3 going on 4 years old, you are 100 years old. You've watched empires rise and fall. You've lived through economic crises that are taught about in history books. You've seen the outbreak of the bloodiest conflicts in human history. You've watched as cars replaced carriages, as film and recorded music took off into the massive industries they are today. You've seen machines go from moderate utilization to performing physical labor on massive scales to thinking for themselves. You have seen so much. The world in 2000 is vastly different than the world in 1900. In the 17 years since 2000, even more has changed. Computers now fit inside of watches. Big ones still exist. They're faster than you can imagine. Screens are everywhere, and peace and quiet is exceedingly hard to find in our connected world. Conflicts still exist, but the biggest problems we face today are of our own creation. Climate change threatens our air, land, and seas. Growing populations test the support systems within our society. New technologies open doors to both miraculous and terrifying prospects for the future. And as far as we can tell, we're just getting started. I cannot imagine what it must be like to have lived through the 1900s and into the 21st century. The experiences held by those 100 plus year old people, I sincerely doubt words do them justice. Getting back to the beginning of this video, it's very likely that if you're alive today, and we don't goof up or nothing random takes you out first, you'll be able to live to see at least 100. If the pace of humanity stays where it is right now, and it rarely does, we tend to accelerate in these things, then you've got a lot left to experience. The most interesting thing in life, in my opinion, is growing older to see the future. Because we're living in someone else's future right now. And every morning we wake up and take a step into our own. So what are you excited for? What do you think would have been the most incredible thing to witness in the past 117 years? If you're not a freaking kid like me, maybe you can tell us about it. I'm Tony from Long Story Short. Thanks for watching.